there's two albums that I've listened to cover to cover without skipping a single song. One of them being the Games documentary. Every song has either got a good beat, something to vibe to, some good lyrics, some real misogynistic shit in there. Or, you know, just the fact that you mentioned his name and that means you lost it, right? So a lot of things about this album, God tier. Then the second album, another hard hitter, another OG in the hood, Taylor Swift, 1989. This shit is literally the best album this broad ever made. I don't know what she did. I don't know what type of fucking, like, drugs or fucking vibes, wine, whatever the fuck magical shit white bitches in Seattle do to fucking channel their inner fucking chakra. Whatever she did for this album, I pray she does it again, because since then, it's been kind of hit or miss. And I'm not talking about the song, I'm talking about the albums that have come out. This shit was god tier, right? Now, with that all being said, right, I put Taylor Swift up there with the Game. You know what I mean? We got two OGs, I respect them both. With that being said, get ready, buckle in, because we about to go on some real incel shit. We about to go on some real, not really incel shit, but just something that I noticed in the latest Taylor Swift song that got me physically upset. Like, it got me mad. Like, it got me... like, it got me so fucking heated, right? So, here's the premise of the song, right? Or the story that goes with this song. You know, young love, you know, you meet each other. There's some misconnections. There's some issues that you run into. A couple of roadblocks. Some that you can't get over. What ends up happening is that something that could be great. Something that could be monumental ends up breaking apart. Things go astray. And eventually, at the end, they give you a little Hallmark moment where the woman's, you know, grown up, she got her career, dude's out in the snow like a bum-ass fuck, and just wondering, like, what if I could have done something different, right? So I watch this shit. I have an open mind. I'm like, yo, let me see. I see no rap features, so how can this be a fucked up song? And I get to a point in the song where the shit goes downhill, and it keeps going downhill. And I'm telling you right now, anyone out there, if you are prone to heart attacks or stress attacks, you better look the fuck away right now, because this shit is going to eat into your asshole like a fucking hemorrhoid. Okay, so pay attention to that scene, right? A little bit, she's a little distant, looks like there's a conversation going on. Just pay attention to that scene, because I swear to God, the only way you could interpret the shit that you just saw in some fucked up, crazy, psycho bitch way is only if you're a fucked up, crazy, psycho bitch.
Why are you so pissed off?
I'm not pissed off. Who said I was pissed off?
Because you're acting pissed off. It's ridiculous. These are my friends. They were super fucking nice to you, too.
Well, I liked your friends. I never said I didn't like your friends. Why I didn't like the way that you acted around them.
You were being weird and quiet the entire time.
I was not being weird because you wouldn't look at me.
Oh, come on.
You can ask me one thing the entire night.
Such bullshit. That's such bullshit.
You dropped my fucking hand. What am I supposed to do with that?
I didn't even fucking know.
Hold up. All right. There's a lot of things to unpack here. All right. First of all, let's start with the obvious, right? Why is my man doing the dishes? He low-key cooked. You know this man cooked. Why are you doing the dishes by yourself? But that's besides the point. Now, this dude, you saw in the last picture frame, he dapped her up. You know, he gave her the dap. You know, she put her... Look, let's go back. We can go back in time. This is the beauty of technology. You can actually go back, right? My man's took her hand, dapped. Look at that dap. Strong dap. No disrespect. It wasn't like he slapped her hand. Wasn't like he did any fuck shit, right? Dapped her up. Look at her face, though. Upset. Salty. In her psychopath mind, he should have altered the conversation. See how everybody here vibing, laughing, having fun, and they go psycho. Like, he was supposed to go, hey, you know, John works at an accounting firm. Doesn't your sister work in an accounting firm? And hold her hand like she's a child and go, here, contribute to the conversation. Come on, let me literally hold your hand and let's contribute to the conversation together. Oh, he works at an accounting firm, right? Yeah, he does. Okay. Let's try a little bit more than one or two word answers, and we're trying to have a conversation here. Like, she's salty that her personality is so low, and her fucking intellect is so little, that he did not literally, physically hold her hand and then mentally and emotionally hold her hand through a conversation between adults. Like, bitch, just say something. Like, even if you ain't got shit popping, just be like, you know, I'm thinking of starting OnlyFans. Just throw something out there. Just lie. Just do something. You just met these motherfuckers. Like, do something interesting. And then here's the thing, right? This is where the psychopath angle comes from. Because we've all been in a group of friends. Maybe you meet some new people. Maybe you say something sus. All of a sudden, people are like, oh, why is he talking about assy? And, you know, sometimes you throw it out there. It's a nice icebreaker, or it goes wrong, right? And instead of her holding the L, being like, hey, you know what? We all have our awkward moments. You know, I got a big-ass forehead. It is what it is. She goes down the psychopath route and goes, why didn't my boyfriend literally hold my hand and cater the conversation around me, what I'm doing, what I'm like, what I'm up to? Why didn't he just do what I wanted without expressing it whatsoever? Like, this is some crazy psychopath shit.
What am I supposed to do with that?
I didn't even fucking notice. What are you talking
about? I don't know any of these people. They're all strangers. They're all older than me.
But, like, what are you talking
about? I feel so out of place. You're the only one that makes me feel
you. I'm like,
look at me.
I'm catching up with friends. You're literally saying I dropped your hand. Like, what? I don't even remember the moment that you're talking about. How can you be like attacking me about something I don't even like fucking know? I was doing it subconsciously. I was catching up with
people. You're making me feel fucking stupid.
Holy shit.
Yeah, that's good. You making yourself feel stupid. Hold up. Hold up. Matter of fact, who about to echo that?
I don't think I'm making you feel that way. I think you're making yourself feel that way.
Literally. Yo, somebody get this motherfucker goddamn Olympic gold medal. This dude just jumped through her mental gymnastics, did a split, and then showed her the fucking stupid award and said, stupid, why are you on my ass when all I did was talk to people? Do you understand? Like, how can someone be upset at you because they were boring? Like, how you in a meeting, you get some jokes off, you get some shit off, and then they start looking at you with the evil eye? They start looking at you like the enemy? No, that's different levels of psycho.
A moment that I don't even fucking remember that you're like, fucking like holding me hostage over. It's insane. It's fucking crazy. These are people I haven't seen in like 10 years. And you just sit there the entire fucking time. It was fun. I actually had a fucking blast. Now this is the night. Now we're doing this. Awesome. So fucking awesome.
You just treated me differently.
What do you mean I treated you differently?
You didn't even look at me once.
What are you?
Yeah, this is crazy. Now this is different levels of crazy. Like, it's like, I don't understand how a person, if you're in a group setting, like, why would everyone turn to you? You're not a child. Like, why would he turn to you, hold your hand, and start talking? Yo, this is some creepy shit. So, she starts off right here with some, like, little bit of ESP shit. Like, you should have read my mind. You should have talked to me. I'm only fucking 12. You need to hold my hand right. They fast forward. You know, she's young, so, you know, you do what you always do. You just hug her and tell her to shut the fuck up. Look how happy she is. It's like a dog. When they shit on the rug and you beat them, they get upset. You give them a cookie, there you go. Now they love you again, right? Now, here's the other part where it gets real fucking spooky and it gets real fucking crazy, right? Is at some point in time before this, right? Before this, they go on a trip to upstate New York, right? And in the lyrics of the song, see, this is where it gets spooky. This is where you gotta understand that this is a fictional story, but Taylor Swift is making the story to be like, oh my God, you know, there's so many relationships that are like this, and it's terrible, and it's abusive, and it shouldn't exist. And, like, in the lyric of the song, she says that, basically, they drove upstate New York. By the way, I don't know if you know this, but, like, for white people, driving upstate is basically, like, leaving the city and going anywhere with, like, four trees or more. And, like, for them, going there is, like, a return to nature. It's some real Adam and Eve type shit, right? So, they're going to nature, they're enjoying themselves, they're looking at fucking leaves, they're leaf peeping. Yo, if you know what leaf peeping means, leave now. Get the fuck out of here. They're leaf peeping, they're looking at all this shit, right? And in the lyric, this is crazy. Yo, hold, I gotta find the lyric. I can't just gloss over this. Alright, I found the lyrics. This shit is worse than I remember, right? So in the video, my mans, they're driving upstate. You know, they're going to return to nature. Whatever, you know, whatever crazy, you know, Adam and Eve type shit, right? And it's at this point where they're driving. I'm gonna mute this, right? So they're driving. He tosses her the keys. Now, this is some crazy symbolism. This is gonna blow your mind. He tossed her the keys, and on the keys it said, fuck the patriarchy keychain, and it went on the ground. Now, that's basically symbolism. That's letting you know that this guy doesn't really believe in fucking the patriarchy. He believes in fucking the fuck patriarchy. That's why he threw it on the ground. And then this is where the crazy goes even crazy. It says, anytime now he's going to say it's love. You never called it what it was till we were dead and gone and buried. Meaning that he basically never showed enough love to her, right? And in this scene, you gotta understand, like, this is where, like, women, like, it's, like, two different fucking worlds. And by the way, this has less to do with women and men and just more to do with sometimes, what's the word I'm looking for? Bum-ass motherfuckers who don't work. Because I, looking at this scene, I could already tell my man's going to upstate New York. This bitch in the car complaining, crying, dying, right? Oh, he won't tell me he loves me. He won't tell me that I'm the best. He won't look at me while driving. Why does he look at the road? Meanwhile, this guy's getting a work call. His aunt, look at that jugular vein. That ain't no regular call. That's a motherfucking manager telling him, why didn't you do this? Why didn't you do that? You're my slave. Why aren't you in your wage cage? And my man out here, right? And this is why I said men or women, because like the lash of the fucking whip, it goes, it's unisexual, right? But usually, it's usually men. Let's be honest. Let's keep it a buck here, right? Let's not get too fucking feminist, right? And he's on the phone with his manager, and she's salty and uptight that he's not saying, I love you. Do you understand, bitch? He just got off the phone with his fucking manager when it's the weekend, and he's supposed to be in upstate New York. There's supposed to be no cell signal. How's this motherfucker getting through? That's how powerful this manager's will and power is, that he can go through fucking cell towers and trees just to get to his phone and drain his fucking energy. And meanwhile, while he's dealing with this bullshit at work, while he's dealing with his fucking girlfriend sitting in the car, the whole time all she's thinking about, what about me? What about my needs? What about the fact that he's looking at someone who isn't me and thinking about things that aren't me? So already this relationship is really great. It's really healthy. Fast forward, right? And it gets to the point where my man is just like, I can't. Like this dude, look at this man. Motherfucker works a 9-to-5, then comes home and he's got to deal with this shit. Like, am I in a relationship or is this a fucking child? Am I raising you, bitch? Do I have to fucking look at you? Do I need to, like, FaceTime you while at work so I continue to look at you? Look at her face. She goes, what? It's an issue staring at me 24 hours a day? So fast forward, he pulls the trigger. He's like, unfortunately, listen, I know I'm literally your entire life. You don't work. You don't go to school. You don't really do much of anything. And you think that I literally just need the revolver on your own hemisphere. But I gotta go, right? He hits the dip. He gets the fuck out of there. And eventually what ends up happening is they think about it. They're like, oh, let's reminisce. What does she do? This is what I love. All Too Well, right? So the character in this fictional story writes an All Too Well book. Dude, this is one thing. I got to tell you something, too. Women, when they get their hearts crushed or when they think they get their hearts crushed, that's when they get their artistic shit, right? That's when they start becoming musicians. That's when they start becoming authors. That's when they start doing the fucking arts and everything, and they just become gods. Like, all you need is one perceived heartbreak. And the reason why I say perceived is because my man was trying to work and hang out with friends, and that somehow was an issue. One perceived heartbreak, and that's it. They fucking multi-billion, zillion, jajillionaires, right? So here she is at her book reading. She's like, I know it all too well. These dog-ass motherfuckers, you know, they don't want to look at you all the time. They don't want to hold your hand. They don't want to fucking tell their boss you're busy while you're upstate New York, right? And as you can see, it ends. And how does it end? My boy, dog, the pit bull, out in the cold, out in the snow, just wondering, what if I could have stayed with her? What if I could have gotten that pussy and some of that millies, some of those $1 million from that book? What if I could have been her rock instead of a literal dickhead? Why did it end like this? Why could I be better than her? And by the way, this is like the craziest fucking like fictional storytelling shit I've ever seen. Because it's like, it's so one-sided in the way that you can interpret this. Because I'm telling you, there's some women who are going to watch this shit, or they might be brainwashed to watch this shit and be like, if only, you know, things could work out, you know, they just weren't synced up. You know, this is just something that's so terrible. This is something that's so sad. Bro, in all these scenarios, all this bitch had to do is stop bugging. That's all she had to do. When I'm driving on the road, looking at the road, I don't need to be looking at you. It's that simple. When I'm on the phone with my manager, why am I getting... Yo, in what universe am I getting chewed out by a manager? I'm going to get off the phone and be like, you know what? That guy just told me I got 2 weeks until I'm fired. But you, I love you. You're the best. You're the best. Who should I say I love to next, right? And then fast forward, my man's having a dinner with his friends. All of a sudden, he's got a... I love how he even says, I haven't seen them for 10 years. Like, I don't know. Real talk, I don't know why he brought her along. Like, keep it a buck. I have no idea why he brought her along. Sometimes, like, dudes just be thinking that, like, they can somehow, like, get brownie points and be like, oh, yeah, come along. It's like when your parents tell you to bring your younger sibling with you and your friends. Like, yeah, come along. It'll be great. No, it ain't going to be great. Because guess what? You need to hold her fucking hand. You need to fucking look at her. You need to involve her in the conversation. Meanwhile, all these motherfuckers are 10 years older. They all have work experience. They all have something they're doing with their life. One bitch got an OnlyFans and $1 million in a bank. And it's like, you can't relate to anything. You ain't in school. You ain't in work. You got no personality. What do? You go to fucking grab this dude's hand and hold on to it like a fucking baby monkey hanging onto its mother's arm, And what does he do? He drops the dap, which is absolutely disrespectful. And then it all basically funnels down the toilet into the culmination of you being a millionaire author. But really, what's funny about this is that this dude out in the cold, I guarantee you, this man out in the cold did not think of this bitch until just now. He was like, oh, shit, ain't that that bitch who always wanted me to look at her and shit? Like, oh, damn, maybe I should catch up. Meanwhile, this woman's life became, like, she took that heartbreak and made her life. I'm going to write a book about it. That's going to be my persona. And really, when you look at this from a perspective of outside the video, like Taylor Swift basically is this woman because she created this entire scenario just to put her own perspectives of this crazy shit on here. And yo, now I know why Taylor Swift got like 20 bodies going through there, bro. They go through. They're like, yo, she's pretty cute. She seems nice. Pretty normal. Oh, hold up. How come I got to stare at her all the time? How come I always got to hold her hand? What is this, a fucking toddler? And then they hit the dips. They got to go. So, listen. I'll tell you right now, any woman that watches this video, and if you're feeling real fucking like a connection with this character, I'd recommend you do two things. One, shut the video. Two, stop. Please just stop. And for any dudes out there, yo, get ready. What this time of year, when it's pumpkin spice season, that's when women get the most gusto. That's when they get the most bravado. They're going to be hitting you with this shit. You could be married 30 years with two kids and have a loving relationship. The bitch going to look at you and say, how come you dropped my hand? You better get ready for that conversation.
At the end of every single video, make sure you ask people to rate and subscribe to your content. It makes them feel like they're involved even though they're really not. And most importantly, make sure they comment on every single video. If you have to, disguise it. You know, call it something like the question of the day. And really make them think you're gonna really read it when you really don't have to. Ha ha ha!